Welcome back to the village of Banpo. Several generations have passed, and the village that your people founded along the banks of the Wei River has prospered. There is a renewed sense of excitement in the town today. Word has just arrived of a nutritious new food source, millet. As a highly respected village elder, you are needed to plan the establishment of farms where millet can be grown to supplement the diet. Hemp farms can also be built. The fibers from the hemp plant have many uses, not the least of which is for durable garments.
Hey guys, welcome back to Emperor, and in this part we're going to continue with Banpo, it looks like, in the second version of it, I say. The goal is simply to get 250 people in an attractive cottage, which is not too difficult, so let's head to the city and read the next tutorial. So the people of Banpo welcome you back, village elder. You will notice that the hunters are still bringing fresh pheasant and delivering it to the village mill, which is busy processing it for the food shop in the market square, as you can see. As you can see, the city is exactly the same. We've got 3,000 strings of cash to deal with this, so it's okay. Meanwhile, in the village, the water car, blah blah blah, is still going well. Things are going well, but your people are tiring of their bland, unbalanced diet. Their dependence on the sole food source is almost over, however, for soon farms will be growing millet, a hardy and healthy grain with many uses. South of the village, on the lower elevation, is a good location for a farm. There's just enough space to get some farms in there, so it's actually really good because you don't have to ensure that farms are connected to things like inspector's towers. They don't collapse, so farming communities should always be disconnected, just blocked off with roadblocks and things like that. Just don't allow people to go out there because there's no reason to. Hunter's tents don't also, I didn't realise this, hunter's tents don't have a risk of fire or collapse. You don't need to connect them to anything either. So as long as you don't have your farming areas connected to anything, it doesn't matter. I didn't mention this in the previous video, but I'll talk about it. There was something else I needed to mention about the housing stuff. I'll mention it in a minute. Ask any farmer, most plants grow best in rich, fertile soil, blah blah blah. It looks interesting. If you keep getting a message stating your city needs more workers, add some more housing, build some hemp shops, etc. You get special dishes when you have extra foodstuffs, and they can combine the game meat and the millet into a special dish, which helps a lot. So it's really just a case of continuing to grow your city. So now we've got aesthetics, so I'll just pause the game. Now you can see that we've got the feng shui harmony auspicious, and that's because obviously we haven't got it all built up yet. You can see feng shui by doing this, by clicking the button obviously. When you hover over things like buildings, it'll tell you what it's associated with. So an inspector's tower is associated with earth, which is rocks. Essential shines is wood, and so on. So you can see a lot of things I've got associations with, like so. So let's just put down a farmhouse. Farmhouses can have multiple crops growing on them, which is really useful in my opinion. So we'll just put that there. We're going to put two millet farms, just one here and one over here, and then a couple of hemp farms. So let's just put... Basically, farms have to have a 3x3 square around them to be able to give food. That's all. We'll just unpause the game and put the food down, like so. That's just a bit close, so what I'm going to do is delete that and move it one tile that way, and then I'll clear that out, like so. You don't really have to worry about cash unless you're really abusing it, obviously. There we go, got that in. And now there's space for them to... As you can see, this is all disconnected to... Well, it is connected as such, but you don't need to ensure that they have access to any kind of things like inspector's towers or all that. Now, one thing I forgot to mention is that unlike in Feral, you do not need a feeder housing. As long as there is housing on the map with workers, they'll get workers just by default, so you don't have to worry too much about things like putting feeder housing in places, so don't worry too much about that. Religion of Nuwa is a bit neglected. Let's just speed this up since our goal is to get some attractive cottages in here. I think they'll need hemp at some point, so I have to account for that as well. Might as well just go ahead and put a hemp shop. Now, there are two types of market squares. You get the common ones started off with, and then you get grand market squares. For the generic housing blocks, is like these, the common housing. You do not need to provide anything more than a common market square, because they won't need access to more than food, hemp, and another goods, which we'll get in the next mission, so don't worry too much about it. How many workers do we need? I think we need more. So we'll just place down some housing like so. Bad feng shui around here, it looks like. Not good. Let's just destroy some of these ancestral shrines, they're not needed now, they're just wasting workers, so... Let's just put a bunch of house... Oh, bad feng shui. I want to try and get good feng shui as much as possible, but I understand that it's not always possible. One house can go in there, that's really annoying, but never mind. Now, things like these inspector's towers can be improved if you place gardens down. And they'll upgrade to fancy inspector's towers, which sends out two workers instead of just the one. Which is really useful in my opinion. I'm just going to try to improve this with gardens. As you can see, it's improved, so that's really good. So is the well. Which is great news. Looks like we can't do anything much more now, except just try and get the hemp in. And as you can see, there's bad feng shui around here, so what we'll do is... let's see... Where to put this? Warehouses have good feng shui near rocks, so try to make sure that they're next to rocks, obviously. Might as well just put this up here and have the hemp go straight up here. And we're only going to put a single hemp farm down. Hemp grows slightly differently to the normal farmhouses. Farmhouses are for things like that your people will eat as food. Hemp and silkworm and all that stuff is different, so don't worry too much about it. For God's sake, there's some bad feng shui around here, it seems. Let's see. I'll just go with a single hemp farm. I don't think we need anything more than that. And as I say, you don't need to ensure that they're connected to anything because they'll get workers. I might rearrange this road and maybe just move that a little bit around just to make use of the space possible. I'm not sure. I might even put a hemp farm or something in this housing area because why not? We can't access any of our industries or any of that right now because we don't have the associated buttons just yet. Now if you click on the titles, you'll be able to get information like this. It does say that you can go to the Commerce tab and stockpile, but I've never actually managed to work out how to do that. So I'm going to have to look up the guide, edit the information and all that. You know, the online manual and that. Now I'm going to delete this hemp farm and just move these tiles over. Let's see if I can maybe move it over one tile. Otherwise I'll get bad feng shui. Not helpful in the slightest, and I'm running out of money as I see here. See, that's okay. When you're building cities, usually... One of the guides that tutorial things I'll try to tell you to do is to mix and match the farms. I don't really recommend that because, in my opinion, it kind of makes the farms a little, I don't know, you just don't get the same amount of yield from it. So what I tend to do is just build loads of farmhouses, but just have them maybe like one or two for just one particular foodstuff. And then I have a constant supply so I can do festivals constantly throughout. Festivals are not like they are in Pharaoh and that, where you hold on to a specific god. It's just done on the Chinese New Year in February, and it's just a generic festival, so don't worry. You won't be able to hold festivals right now because you don't have entertainment just right now. So I basically need to get a hemp farm running ASAP, because we've got our billet coming in as you can see. Just put a hemp farm. farm there just for no reason. Don't worry about money because the money won't carry over. Hemp farm coverage is smaller than it is on a normal farmhouse, so just be aware of that. A farmhouse has an extra tile of space, but hemp farms are a bit smaller, but they produce a lot more. At the beginning of the campaign, the first three kind of campaigns, hemp actually has no use of it to give it to your people. I think it's about a fourth campaign where you have to use it for something else, but I'm not going to spoil her too much about it. So let's just take a save. I know I'm going to run a massive debt and run out of credit. It doesn't matter in the tutorial missions whether you run out of credit or not, because that's not the point. Making money is not the point of these tutorial missions. I'm simply going to get hemp in here and then we'll be done with this mission. Just got to grow some hemp. I might just say sod the feng shui. I know we've got perfect harmony, that's not too bad. Obviously I'm not shooting for perfect harmony or any of that nonsense, so don't worry. I'm just trying to get at least harmonious balance in all the missions. Ah, here we go, hemp's going out into season, which is good. Now the more workers that a farm has, the more people it sends out to cultivate the farms, so just be aware of that. Now I realise there isn't much to do now because we've provided the millet. We just need to give them the needed hemp to evolve. Yeah, food tends to be a bit of a runaway problem. As you can see, unlike in Faro where the flood kind of dealt with things, which is unpredictable obviously, farms tend to be quite productive, and as you can see we can feed about like 2,000 people in this one city with all the food we're growing. So in fact I'm going to just sod the bad feng shui here and just get more people in here because it looks as if it's not helping much. Some gardens like so. The only buildings that improve with gardens and that is wells, inspector's towers and watchtowers. Nothing else evolves if you beautify it in terms of they become better. That makes sense. 500 people, that's good. I don't think we can. We have a city summary which tells you whether a few basic things, and you can file requests on the bottom as well, so that's quite nice. So once this hemp comes in we'll be fine, it looks like. And we'll get on to more of the trading stuff in the next mission, I think. Yeah, I know hygiene's good, but worse than we don't have access to anything like herbalist stalls and things like that. I do like hemp, it's a really good game. It's a shame I didn't get it before, but whatever. We've got the hemp delivered, which is good. We'll just save again, and these houses will evolve. Like so. 242, so they're evolved, and that's just done with the mission, which is great news. For us, I think we've got a bit too much housing in here, but we can clear it out in the next mission when we get access to industry, which allows us to see how much workers we need and alter wage rates. Wage rates are quite a sticky thing, but I won't go into too much detail about it. There we go, done.
Congratulations. Under your wise tutelage, the people of your village have mastered the new art of farming. Thanks to you, they now reside in much sturdier, more attractive cottages.
Of course. And in the next mission, must have done with this one, in the next mission we'll be returning to Banpo for the third time and continue with the tutorial, and I think we learn about trade in the next one. So thanks for watching, see you in the next video guys, bye now.